Yo, it's Briz One, or Matthew Hawkins, whatever. This is my first ever trip report video about when I was on LSD. The second time, I'll tell you the first time another time. I'm pretty fucking sick at the moment. Just want to say to any cunt who knows me on Facebook and that, and if you are fully against drugs or whatever, and you want to go and call the police or whatever, you're wasting your fucking time. I do not have nothing in my house, so don't even bother. I don't even have a bong. I smoke weed, but I don't have a bong, so you're wasting your time. That's all I got to say about that. Anyway, this first time, I'll get straight into it. Alright, this first time, second time I've done LSD. I did it with my mate. I don't know if I should say his name, but I don't give a fuck, Dale. No, that's all I'm just going to say. I won't say his last name, but yeah, me and my mate Dale, I knew a dude who to go get LSD from, $25 a hit, and normally it's 20, but he was low on it, but anyway, after we got it, we put it straight under our tongue. It was the little blotters, probably about fucking that big, not big at all, but it was very potent shit. Put it that way, it was more potent, it was the same dude and everything as my first time, it's more potent than last time, fucking, he even told us that, but fucking, Dale had LSD before, but it was kind of, I don't know if it was fake or whatever, because I didn't do it with him, but he didn't get the visuals that you normally get with LSD. Anyway, fucking, this is in Rangbar in Brisbane. We dropped it at Woolies. Takes about, you have it under your tongue for half an hour with these ones, and you chew it, swallow it, do whatever. I chew and swallow it after half an hour under my tongue. And about half an hour later, it hits you. And I'm a skater as well, so Dale had his board, decided to go for an adventure. Now, we went to the soccer fields and baseball fields. We were sitting there and we were just having a skate on flat ground, just doing whatever. And then I kind of knew the feeling straight away. And yeah, about half an hour passed and my head started feeling real heavy and shit. So I tried to do a kickflip, and I was doing them all before, and I was doing nollie flips, blah, blah, blah. Fucking, then all of a sudden it was hard to do a fucking kickflip. Then I knew it was kicking in. So I sat down, rolled a smoke, and I was just watching Dale skate. Now, I was staring at the ground, I started zoning out a fair bit, like when you're stoned, and fucking, I was staring at the ground, and then all the things on the ground, so like, people's gum, fucking cracks, bits of like, I don't know, whatever's on the ground, little rocks, all of it started having, I don't know, patterns coming from the sides of them, starting to come out. It's kind of like, merge in, merge out, and it'll go away for a few seconds and come back and then merge, but it got stronger every time it came back. And fucking sitting there, and I started thinking, holy shit, it's starting. Dale's looking at me like, you're fucked, like, you're a fucking trooper, you don't know what you're on about. And I remember this part so good. Dale was about to hop on his board about 10 minutes later, and as he stood on it, he started having a bit of a freak out. He looked at, he's like, holy shit, I see what you mean. And then, yeah, we decided to go for a walk then. We started walking. If you live in Rangbar or around that area, you know where the bridge is at, around the North Lakes area, North Oak Lake, sorry. Yeah, we're going across that bridge, and Dale started having a bit of a scare moment of, holy shit, I didn't expect for this, but he kind of forgot about that pretty quick. And we went for a walk up this hill, we were heading to Burpengary, and yeah, we're just skating along, and it was fully kicking in, fucking, it started. I was seeing shit coming out of the ground, trees and shit were changing, it was just hectic, like flickers. So like, say a tree is here, and in your vision it'll go like real fast back, and fucking, oh, it's trippy. Anyway, we were going along, and I remember these two girls, Dale's, started yelling out to him, and then that happened. If you know what lads are, you know what I'm talking about. There happened to be a party of lads, and they were their girls, and Dale was talking shit, and they happened to hear. I remember we ran up to where, up the hill, where the Burpengary train line starts and you turn left and you head to the train station, and fucking Dale turned right and ran into bushes and I turned left. I kind of forgot about the lads like pretty quick because I was that out of it, and Dale was hiding in the bushes. I had to keep calling him to come out. They didn't even come after us as we were yelling and shit. But yeah, no, we headed to the train station. Trippy shit happened, like Brisbane, it's lit up. Fucking, we're walking to the train station and next minute all these bright lights and shit are in our face. We're tripping hard out. And then all the burping Gary just shuts off, like, everything just, boom, just lights and everything turn off, and there was two girls at the train station. Dale walks past pretending he was the devil and shit, just tripping them out, and they thought we're idiots, obviously, we're fucking gone. And we're heading to a mate's place, by the way, and fucking, as we were crossing the main road, all the lights turned on, and then looked to the right to go across the road. The next minute happened to be a police car. Them cunts actually stopped and pulled us over. And I remember it so bad. Like, I was sitting there and Dale, he was getting interrogated and by one copper next to me. And then they stayed in the car. They didn't get out. But I had to talk to the chick and she was in the driver's seat. So this is in Australia. So she was fucking on the other side of the car. So I had to lean in the window. My pupils are probably boom. But we realised a couple of days later that fucking, that when you look into a light, your pupils actually go down. So they're dickheads if they shine lights in your eyes when you're on something like that. Anyway, yeah, I was leaning in the car and I heard the other fella ask Dale to spell his last name when they just ask their questions and shit. It's normal street check. Like, oh, I asked this, like, what our names were, where we live, blah, blah, blah. And yeah, Dale had to spell his last name, and I remember just sitting there and going, oh fuck, we're fucked, he can't spell his last name, there's no way. Obviously he could, but yeah, I thought, oh, he's fucked. And then I remember sitting there, and my last name's Hawkins, and I was sitting there, and then she's like, can you spell your last name please? And I was like, what? And then she's like, spell your last name. I'm like, Hawkins, like, really fast, and, you know, she believed it, and I remember this bitch, I was, like, staring at a police uniform, and it was, like, patterns and shit, and all these colours coming out of it. I started just, with LSD, the more you stare at the trip, the more you get sunk into it, and it's harder to hear things around you, because you're just so focused, like, your mind is just going, trip. But fucking, yeah, and then I remember looking down to her belt to stop that focusing shit, and her belt, she had like a little Batman thing. Oh, I lost my shit. And then, but anyway, they told us we could go, and then I was like, alright, we're all good. Nah, I happened to actually be, they're like, alright, see yous later, and I'm like, see you later, man. And he's like, what, you want to see yous later? I'm like, yeah, no, and then, yeah, eventually we got away, and then we went skating and stuff, and staring at trains on that shit is just, you lose your shit, you do lose your shit. Anyway, fucking, sorry if this goes for so long, it's a pretty big night, then we headed off, went for a massive walk, played in the park and shit, and just tripped out, sat next to the main road, watching cars go past, just tripping out hardcore. Then we went to our old primary school, and we were sitting in there for a bit, and staring at the ground, and, yeah, just tripping out, and I saw this grub, man, it was, like, tie-dye colours coming from around it and stuff, and it was trippy as. Anyway, we left there, and, we were walking along this park. Now, this is trippy, this is just, we lost our shit how this worked out, but where the road we were on, you can see exactly, like, you got a roundabout up here, then comes down into a road, and you got a park, and you have to go down around the park and come back up. And even the shortcut, where I could see down, and no cars came from behind me to go down the shortcut to get where they were. We were walking, and I remember seeing cop cars go along the main road, but they didn't come down our way, and then I looked to the left, and it was just, cop car just came out of nowhere, and they pulled us up, and these coppers did not look normal. I don't know, I still don't know to this day if it was just a hectic fucking acid, and this was a whole trip fucking thing, but, yeah, coppers hopped out, and it was like a movie. Like, it was like they were out of a movie. They didn't look like proper coppers. They just looked like actors, kind of thing. But yeah, they were doing the same as the last coppers, just checking what we're doing and stuff. We're tripping on LSD, tripping the fuck out. And I remember Dale telling me he's losing his shit, and he's gonna tell him, yeah, I'm on LSD. But thank fuck he didn't, because we got away. But he's sitting there getting interrogated, and but then they eventually started in conversation with us, and then I see this, we told them we were in the school, and they didn't really care, but this car pulled up, and it had top lights, and I was thinking, oh, fuck, there's more coppers, where fuck, for something that we didn't do or something, and this car pulls up, and no one gets out of it, and stays there, and I just stare at it for ages, and I figured it out as a taxi. I'm like, hell yeah, not other coppers, and then the coppers let us go, and we started walking off. Dale wanted to go to turn right, which is just a dead-end street. I tried to tell him that. He did not believe me, but yeah. And then these big fucking gym junkie cunts got out of the taxi, and they were drunk as fuck, like pulling trees out and going off and throwing shit. And I just wanted to get out of there because, didn't want to get bashed or some shit by four gym junkies, and there's only two of us, and anyway, we got out of there and fucking went the wrong way, came back, went up, didn't have to deal with them. And it came to the last bit of the night where it's just a long, huge hill, and this hill is fucking pretty crazy. And I'm like, I don't mind. I used to do it every morning and go to school, so I just see a day or I'll see it at the bottom, and I was flying down this hill, and that thing about the flickers, fucking, I was coming down halfway down the hill. And I'm flying. I'm probably going like 70k on a skateboard, just flying down this hill. I'm only halfway down it. I look at this tree, and it flickers like in front of me and then back, and I shit myself. I thought the tree actually like fell over and I was going to hit it, but I managed to stay on, made it to the bottom, and then I went into the park, and I was swinging on the swing for ages while I was waiting for Dale, and then we went back to where we started. We were in the same place at the soccer fields, and yeah, we were sitting there for a bit. The next minute, there's a fucking cop car again. We just got sick of it and just legged it, and then Dale sat there for a while in the bush wanting to fucking just go to sleep and thinking he was going to get caught, but we went back to his house, snuck back in, didn't get caught. We didn't really sneak in, like, we were allowed to go out and shit, but he just didn't want his parents to see something, like, just tripping off our head. But, yeah, oh, it's crazy, it's a very good night, it's a very good drug, it's very fun, and we had a crazy night, like, our mind was going, like, it's like, everything was amazing, but when bad shit happens, it's like, it's a cartoon, it's like, it's not actually gonna happen, and, like, you're staring at the cops' faces, and, like, 21 Jump Street, when you see, like, the eyebrows do that thing, that literally happened to me. I can't not lose my shit when I look at people's faces. It looks like the face goes from being real to plastic to real to plastic. Oh, fuck. It's crazy shit, but it's fun. It's very, very potent ones are good. I've only done LSD twice, but yeah, oh, it's so fun. But yeah, fucking, yeah, it's your choice if you want to do them. I'm not saying do them. I'm just here to tell stories about shit. But it's my first trip report about being on LSD with a mate. And yeah, fucking, your choice to do it, your choice to not do it, your choice to hate me, your choice not to hate me. It doesn't really fucking matter because I really don't care. But yeah, more of these coming soon. I don't know how many. I've got a few I can fucking tell. I know that. But there might be more times where I take some in the future, and yeah, but back to when people dub me in, because you just know my name and shit, because it's on my fucking YouTube channel anyway, I can't hide my name, so tell the coppers and shit, I don't care, I got nothing in my house, they're going to raid my house, and then they're probably going to call you back and call you a fuckhead, so yeah, I'm going to go now, but fucking, yeah. More troop reports soon. Brisbane out.